quick intro for this video. Just threw this together real quick. Quick ride on my Honda Cubby, little 70cc mini motorcycle type thing, scooter, if you will, not moped because it doesn't have pedals. And I just wanted to take you guys along and had a little bit of conversation in my helmet with my new microphone, and hopefully you enjoy it.
Okay, it's a test of the helmet vlogging setup with this Honda little Cubby. Little Cubby. What up, little Cubby? What up, little Cubby? It is fucking 70 degrees right now, despite these giant gloves that I'm putting on. And it's the middle of March. And we're gonna do some crime. We're gonna do some fucking crime today. I had this under a tarp all winter. And I just took it out from underneath the tarp. And you know what? Fucking thing fired right up. Because it's a Cub, it's a Honda Cub, 1981 C70 to be exact. And goddamn, I have to actually twist these wires together here, if you can see. These wires are my ignition switch, because the one I bought was some like generic thing that wasn't really an ignition switch. So I think I'm ready. Put air in the tires. I half-assed the chain. Lubricated the chain, that is. God, this thing feels illegal. I shouldn't be able to ride this. This is great. I have to remember how to do it. So fucking weird. You kind of have to shift up in a weird way to make this shit work. Okay. Monday night, we call it crime night. Hey cuties! That's my beautiful wife and my beautiful doggie. They're out for a walk while I'm going out for a ride. Boys, meeting up the boys for crime night. Monday night motorbikes, we're doing a bit of crime this evening. We got the crime bikes. We call them the crime bikes because they're tiny and you can do crime on them. Big bikes are for sophisticated gentlemen. Sophisticated gentlemen who have responsibilities. These bikes are crime bikes. They are not sophisticated. They're for doing crime. If you're gonna rob a bank, you don't want to try to take off on a freaking K16 GTL. No. Wait, how are you gonna get that down the back alley? How are you gonna take that down a flight of stairs, motherfucker? I didn't think so. You're not gonna do that. You're gonna take a Cubby. You're gonna take some of this other shit. So I'm going downtown now, and hopefully you can hear me okay in my new little setup here, and we'll see what happens with the boys tonight. For crime, we're doing crime tonight. Okay, should try not to kill myself doing crime here though. Oh god, gonna have to bring out the bugs there. Everyone loves this thing. Everyone smiles at you. Everyone waves. It's fantastic. I'm going to sell it, but I kind of don't want to. None of the lights really work. I mean, they turn on, but nobody's going to fucking see you with them. Okay, then you gotta kind of feather the... From what I remember, you got to kind of feather the fucking choke to make it do what it's supposed to do. Yeah, we got a red light. But it seems to be working okay. Getting right up to 30, no problem. I'm going to stop for gas because Lord knows how much gas I left in this fucking thing in the fall. My one shitty mirror. Break down my shitty wall.
Doing almost 40. And I think I had a bit of an exhaust leak today because I took it out. So I just tightened the exhaust manifold bolts, and man, I've never remember it pulling that hard at 40 miles an hour before. I think it helps to have the back pressure or whatever the fuck you want to call it. I think that's the terminology.
The microphone's like touching my chin, so it's probably not optimally placed there. We'll see how it turns out. Oh, fuck, I'm in the wrong lane. I'm in the wrong fucking lane. Can I get out of here? Nope, I'll die. I will easily die. Alright. Full speed, baby! Yeah! That's 20! That's 20! Man, it really does pull though. Holy shit, this is... I might not be able to sell this thing. Fuck. I think I've run out of gas. I'm hoping. I just so happen to be right at a fucking gas station. Holy hell, that's awesome. I don't know what the cops are doing up here, but hoping I can get some gas to make this run. Either that or I clogged like the carburetor and I'm fucked. But I'm hoping it's just like running out of gas here. Because that's what it normally feels like when it's running out of gas, frankly. So, okay, let's give this a shot. There's a shitload of gas in there still, so I have no idea. Okay, you gotta go real, real fucking slow with this. Or else you're in trouble. So what did we put in? 0.3? So, I mean, it had at least a half a tank in there. It's nice to have some fresh stuff, so I'm hoping it's not bogging down because the carburetor's like fucked up here. It seems to be running okay now. Twist. Oh, yeah, this is how you do it. This is how they did it back in the olden days. Like when they were riding horses and stuff. Pretty sure. Actually sounds okay. Let's see what happens. What are these cops doing over here? Do I want to even mess with this? Especially considering I don't know if I have a current registration for this right now. Yeah, we'll hit it. All right. Oh, I think he just wants more choke is all. What's up? Oh yeah, he's a Harley. He's too tough. He's too tough to say hi to this bad boy. He's got too big of balls for this machine. Yeah, that's all it was. It wants choke after a while. It probably has carburation issues, but it kind of always done that, so. All right, park cab, baby. Oh, got it. Pop, pop, pop. Yeah, it's pretty typical, though. I think, apart from carburation issues, probably has some ignition timing woes there as well. It's got gas, so we know that. Stalled it, but it's just because... Yeah, it just runs real fucking rich at the top end or something. I don't know. Come on, motherfucker. It just needs more choke. Actually, it means it runs lean, doesn't it? Not sure what it does. We're almost there. Probably like carburation stuff too. It's been sitting for a long fucking time. I should put some cleaner in there. You know, it's probably run 100 miles in the past year. If that. Okay, almost there. We're gonna make it, boys. Oh, come on, motherfucker. There we go again. Another stall situation. Fuck you, come on. Yeah, she's been and popping. I hope that after some riding it'll get better here. Here, yes, this used to be one way and now it's not. Oh, come on, motherfucker. Oh, damn it, locked the rear wheel right up. Come on, dude, come on. Okay, we're here. Brian's here. If I could figure out how to make this run right. Hey, what's up? I'm having trouble, man. I can't like get this thing to run well. I think I just forgot. Like, there's always like a song and dance you need to like feather the choke just the right way.
Power to help you walk in, but I'm just kind of ridiculous.
So we're walking. Because my bike will not run at all now. I'm gonna drop it off at my shop and pick up a proper e-bike because gasoline, that's why.
In a way, I wanna be on big motorcycles and I wish Matt had one that was not.
3 days later.
Well, it is a couple days later. It's Thursday now. And long story short, she's running once again with very little effort. And what it turned out to be, I pulled it into the shop here at Interstellar, rolled it in there, and then pulled off the fuel lines from the gas tank, and no gas came out. And I just filled it up on the way over, so I said, what the heck is going on? And then I remembered, this has an issue, if there's a big change in temperature, the fuel will just not come out of the tank. It's kind of like Bernoulli, like if you fill it up and, you know, seal it completely, it somehow creates a vacuum. It doesn't allow it to come out. So, needless to say, I just cracked the fuel tank and it came just started working again. That's all I needed to do probably on Monday as well, but it's okay, it worked out. We had fun, everyone was on e-bikes anyway, so it ended up working out that way. And now we go for a ride home. It's kind of warm for all this stuff, but yeah, it should work. Okay, fuel is on. Rock and roll. There she is. Didn't really expect to get out of here today. I figured I would just be cleaning the carburetor, but it's not the carburetor at all. It was pretty ironic that on the way here, I talked about how great it was running and how hard it was pulling, and then stopped. But it's doing okay again. Stop creeping out, motherfucker. Hate fucking people who do that, because I have no idea what your plan is. Okay. Okay. Give you a little bit of background on this little bike I'm riding today. It is a 1981 Honda C70. Some might call it a cup. Some might call it a passport. Passport was the name we were given here in 1981. There's no cup logos or badging, but it's the same fucking bike. And I believe they called it a cup in the 60s and 70s. And I don't know, fucking marketing, you know? No idea. But of course it is the most winningest motor vehicle, not just motorcycle, motor vehicle of all time. There are more of these produced than any other motor vehicle ever made, and probably ever will be made. Something like 100 million. And that's just the ones that are legit from Honda. That doesn't include all the clones that were made, you know, in the following like 30 years after, you know, many more were made in like China and Thailand, and yeah, but there are derivative bikes everywhere. India, all that kind of shit. Tons. God, this has got some good pickup to it now. So this is only 70cc. Brand new, it does 47. It'll do that now, here and there. I have knobbies on it because originally I thought it would be good to have as a winter bike. It's nice kickstart, very light, easy to handle. It's actually kind of awkward to handle in a lot of ways. It's like real twitchy. It's got this awkward leading link suspension. It's kind of got like a little tiny mini swing arm on the front of the fork. Rigid fork all the way up to that point has like half an inch of travel. But when you get on the brakes, like I just did there, you can see that the front end, it doesn't dive. It does the opposite of dive. It rises up when you hit the brake, which is fucking weird. And it doesn't help, control very much. Now, in fairness, this thing is work, and I'm sure with a modern, I think of the modern, you know, Cubs and Passports and whatever the fuck they call them. I think they have another name even in the UK, but they have a little bit more. They have a little bit better suspension. They actually have like telescopic forks and stuff like that. And the new Cub, you know, they re-released the Cub. It has a 125cc like fuel injected motor, which is great. Hey, Gary. Okay, so that goes fast enough, though, really, for the city. It's pretty good, and that's only a 70. They made 50s, they made 70s, they made 125s. They made everything, and they have a fuel-injected 125 on the new ones, but they're real cutesy. They're not real, kind of rugged in the same way that these. This bike is made for some shit. You see some photos of this bike in Thailand, China, in India, in many other countries where it's an essential form of transport, these motherfucking things will be carrying, you know, crates and crates of whatever items they need to take, whatever place. This is not a cutesy transport for those folks. This is like an essential tool for getting places. And that I have a lot of respect for. It does do upwards of 100 miles per gallon, assuming that you're not like, you know, draining the gas out every other tank for, you know, trying to clean the carburetor or whatever. But yeah, I've definitely gotten about 100 miles per gallon legitimately, which there's not many bikes that can actually do that. People say that, but it's pretty rare. It has to be pretty small, and it has to be, frankly, kind of slow, because the energy it takes to go 60 miles an hour on a motorcycle goes up exponentially from 40. These people aren't going to be happy that I'm in front of them. But we'll try to give them a run for their money. I'm going to crouch real here, and then you give you a... Here's a speedo cam. Going a little faster. Lean it out a little bit with the... joke. Usually it'll do more than 40, but it's taking its sweet time getting there. This is pretty typical. Oh, come on, don't make me stop. Okay. Drum brakes, front and rear. Powerful, powerful machine. It's efficient, though. They actually grab okay. I mean, I felt worse disc brakes, actually. Some of the earlier disc brakes suck. Pretty cool bike, really. I'm probably still gonna get rid of it because I don't know. I have too many bikes, I guess. But it's comfortable too. It's real easy, unintimidated. Everything's very low, very light and low. Okay, let's give it a full pull here. Whatever that means. I'm pretty sure that's like a tractor pull there. I don't know where that came from. I should have been down one gear. It's already in third gear. This has three gears, by the way. Semi-automatic transmission. No clutch. No clutchy. It just kind of clutches its way back into gear as soon as you let off the shifterator down there. The clutch is... There is a clutch just like built into the shift lever. Hard to explain until you've tried it. Damn, I thought I could get a couple more mile an hour, but I do have knobbies on here. A little more rolling resistance. I do like the fact that this thing is obnoxiously loud, and I'm not really that kind of guy, but these motherfuckers are trying to kill me, dawg. the exact speed run to the Burp Monroe here. Sorry about that zip tie. It's holding on my little auxiliary headlight just in case I was coming home late and I didn't trust the headlight on this thing. If they don't, it's like kind of useless. That's about the sweet spot right there. Once I get over 40, it tends to keep going. It won't rev past there because it can't quite build up the power in that third gear. If I had like another gear, it'd probably make it up there a little easier. But the gears are kind of tall for what it is. I don't know. Anyway, this is probably where I end the vlog. I don't think there's a whole lot more interesting things I have to say about this bike. It is old. It has been through some shit. But I don't know if you're going to be able to hear it. This thing is loud. This thing is the loudest bike I own by a significant margin. But it's kind of okay because otherwise people will kill you. But I cleaned it up, make it all shiny, and then put it on Facebook, Craigslist, see if I can get any bites here. Great bike, but I think that this form factor today, small, lightweight bike, easy to handle. This is better served with an electric bike, in my opinion. If you took this exact thing, say you could do 45 miles an hour, that's, you know, say a 3-kilowatt hub motor with, this whole format weighs about 150 pounds, so you could probably get 3-4 kilowatt hours in there, which would easily be a round town 100 mile thing, which is what this does. You throw a little J plug charger on there, it would be way better bike than this, and it wouldn't do all this crazy spitting and popping bullshit that I'm dealing with. But it would also not be able to go 100 miles on about 6 pounds of gasoline or 5 pounds of gasoline.
I do really appreciate bikes as transportation, so that's why I think this is a cool bike to be reviewing, sort of, as opposed to like big motorcycle-y shit. It's crazy efficient. There was one more thing I did want to mention. At one point, they did talk about how this bike was actually more efficient than a human riding a bicycle. This was done like back in like the 60s or 70s, so I remember reading about it, and I don't know, as a nerd, I've always just thought this shit was fascinating, that this could actually be more efficient now. It depends on how you do the math, and if you take everything into account, the whole kind of systems approach, that's likely not true, you know? But, when that gas ran out of the carburetor, hopefully. But, you know, it's still super and crazy efficient. I mean, let's put it in neutral. All the way down is neutral. So it's real, real efficient. I mean, it's at 100 miles per gallon. It, you know, like I said, only 40 miles an hour. But, you know, there is a certain amount of energy it takes to grow the food, to feed the human, to make the bike go. And at some point, somebody kind of did the math and said, hey, it's actually probably more efficient to put, you know, just gasoline energy, you know, dead dinosaurs, and you know, make it go that way. What am I leaking there? See, this thing is just a constant struggle, this motherfucking thing. Disconnect my headlight. So, alright, I'm done now. This is it. This is the end of this adventure, and I guess we'll see you next time on Troy's Ride Hacks.